Sawadee ka and good evening. Welcome to Thai PBS World Tonight. I'm Nabunag.
And I'm Hatayte Shekitiranan, and kicking off the program tonight. It's been almost 4 weeks now after the Phuket Sandbox program. Let's take a look about what the situation has been on at the moment. The Phuket Sandbox scheme, in which fully vaccinated COVID-19 negative foreigners allow into the country through the island without quarantine as an initial step in the country's reopening to international arrivals, will continue despite the announcement of closures of more venues in response to rising corona's infections on the island and in many parts of the country. Phuket Governor Norong Woon Siu said the increase of the new infections to 28 cases yesterday, one of whom among international arrivals with a few returnees from other provinces and the rest local transmissions, does not mean that the scheme will be cancelled. Daily local infections in the province remain single digits for some time before increasing to two digits last week from July 22nd. The Phuket Provincial Communicable Disease Committee has decided to close down the island's Central Festival and Central Florista Mall, the provincial sports stadium, soccer fields, and futsal courts until August 2nd as a precautionary step to maintain and contain further spread of COVID-19. All schools and other educational institutes are now closed until August 16, while social distancing is being enforced in night and fresh markets, with the number of visitors limited to 4 square meters per person until further notice. Public gatherings of no more than 100 people are permissible, as the governor explained the need for tighter restrictions amid surging infections. Cumulative infections in the province since April 1st are 958, including 191 cases still being treated. The island's death toll is 11, including one yesterday. According to the provincial health chief, new infections are expected to stabilize at about 20 cases a day for the next 2 weeks because there remain many high-risk cases in quarantine pending test results. He attributed the increased infections to the arrival of more people on the resort island to seek jobs and more tourists, adding that the infection surge will not pose an obstacle to the continuation of the Phuket Sandbox scheme. And since July 25th, people entering Phuket must be fully inoculated and have tested negative for COVID-19 in the 72 hours immediately prior to arrival. Bangkok authorities began sending asymptomatic and mild COVID-19 cases back to the northeastern region of Thailand today on Tuesday for isolation and treatment, as the capital, which is the epicenter of the current wave, runs out of hospital beds. 135 green or mild asymptomatic patients are being transported on a special train to their hometowns in Buriram, Surin, Sisaket, Ubon Ratchathani, Amnadjaru, and Yesothon, and Nakhon Ratchasima today. The train will only stop at the pre-planned destinations, while close supervision by medics are provided on the train. Ambulances would be waiting for the patients as they arrive to take them to designated isolation areas. Bangkok currently has 3,515 beds to accommodate COVID-19 patients in hospitals, field hospitals, and hospitals, which are now almost fully occupied, leaving many people waiting in home isolation for vacant beds, according to Bangkok's medical department, which is planning to find 3,500 more beds for people whose symptoms are at the medium level and about 40 more beds for severe cases. Among new venues to be used for new COVID cases are sleeper trains, with a plan to open 240 beds in 15 train carriages this Friday, July 30th, for green cases. Over 3,300 people infected with COVID in Bangkok have been in home isolation to date. 915 have recovered, while 455 others have been taken to hospitals for treatment.
Now let's move on to something else that has nothing to do with COVID-19. You may have heard about this news since yesterday. UNESCO's World Heritage Committee, or the WHC, agreed to list Thailand's Kengkrachan Forest Complex as a World Natural Heritage Site during its 44th session held online between July 16 and the 31st in China's Fuzhou City. The successful listing of the forest represents the culmination of 10 years of effort by various Thai governments to push for its listing. It is Thailand's third natural heritage site to be endorsed by the WHC. Kengkrachan Forest Complex is Thailand's largest national park, covering up to 464,000 hectares spanning Phetchaburi, Prachob Kirikan, and Ratchaburi provinces. The forest is rich in over 490 wildlife species. Several of them are rare, such as tigers, tapirs, and freshwater crocodiles. At the 43rd session of UNESCO's World Heritage Committee, held in Baku, the capital of Azerbaijan, in 2019, the committee deferred Thailand's nomination for the second time due to human rights violations against the Karen indigenous people living in the forest. The WHC suggested that Thailand address the demands of the Karen forest dwellers, the human rights violation allegations, and seek input from the local communities. The Thai government responded to the WHC's proposal by setting up a committee to resolve land rights disputes with the Karen villagers and has introduced several development projects to improve the livelihoods of the forest dwellers. Community leaders have also been invited to take part in sharing their views on park management.
And with that, we wrap up tonight's program. Don't forget to follow us on Twitter, Facebook, Instagram, YouTube, TikTok, and our website, www.thaipbsworld.com, for all the latest updates and analyses.
Thanks for watching. Stay safe, and we'll see you tomorrow. สวัสดีค่ะ
สวัสดีค่ะ